Hello, and welcome to C++ Weekly. I am your host, Jason Turner. I am available for code reviews and on-site training. Now, in this episode, I want to talk about the parallel algorithms, which we haven't really talked about at all. But in the right scenario, they're magic. So stay tuned. So what I have here is a simple Mandelbrot renderer, and I've done this in several languages now. It's one of the things that I like to do when I'm playing with a new tool is make a Mandelbrot renderer. This one is, well, it's pretty simple. And just so you know, yes, this is in fact available up on the official C++ Weekly GitHub project. And I have this absolutely terrible little make Mandelbrot script here, and some of these things are completely useless, I'm sure. I don't have a CMake file for it. It should be updated. There's so many things that are wrong with this code, but it was a fun little project at one time that I have pulled forward through a couple of different iterations in C++ things. So I'm just going to go ahead and run this make Mandelbrot script. And this is clearly specific to my system here, and you'll notice I'm getting this TBB error, and that's because I'm including the parallel algorithms header. This is a very simple single-threaded Mandelbrot renderer, and I'm gonna run it here, and I have really no idea what kind of performance I expect to get with the recording going on here, but this max iterations rendered in 1.99 seconds here, this is the key thing that we're going to pay attention to. And that is how long it takes to reach the max iterations. Now, for the sake of feedback, I render a single frame of this at some nominal number of iterations. Now, the way Mandelbrot works is you keep iterating on a value until you decide that you've reached, you know, some end point or whatever. So certain parts of the Mandelbrot set are actually faster to render or slower to render than other parts of the Mandelbrot set. So it has to, you know, we want visible feedback as quickly as possible. So I do some amount of rendering iterations, and even if I haven't hit the endpoint, then I just display that to the screen. And here I've zoomed in on this particular portion of the Mandelbrot set that I like, and we can see it's taking about 1.9 seconds to finally decide, okay, I have gone as deep into this as I can. And again, I'm recording and rendering on the same computer, so I'm just going to back out a little bit, but I expect that we're going to see, yeah, there we go. This part of the set is 1 second. And you can, you know, move around and whatever with the arrow keys. And if you hold down shift, then you get the faster increments into these things. And I'm using page up and page down to zoom in and zoom out on it. The window's not resizable. It's all very simple, done in SFML. But this is kind of slow. Mandelbrot is what is known as trivially parallelizable. That is, each pixel can be calculated independently without any other input from any other surrounding thing. So let's go ahead and parallelize this. Now, what I have in here, this is my transform function. So what I have is the set of pixels that I want to calculate. And I just have this function called getColor. GetColor takes the point, and it needs other information about how it's rendering it. What is the current center that we are trying to render at? How many iterations do we want to try to go? And this is all complex numbers, so this I'm using std complex here. And I haven't covered this standard complex at all on C++ Weekly. It's actually on my to-do list to do an episode about it specifically. So while iteration is less than stop iteration, it's just going to go through and keep trying to like refine the point. It's going to do as many calculations, as many iterations as it can until it finds some interesting value there. And I've got these other modes like absolute value, and I can change which power of the Mandelbrot set I want to render and that kind of thing. And this code is not great. This code could definitely be improved upon. There's no question in my mind that it could be improved upon. But let's go ahead and get back to this transform. So this transform takes a set of input points and creates a set of output points. And you can see this entire interface should be redesigned. It's not really safe. I'm doing things that are not quite thread safe. And how I get that image buffer back to be displayed. So that's probably bad, but I'm not going to worry about it at the moment. I'm going to focus on this, the actual calculation work happening here. So I've got standard transform from the begin to the end, and then I say I want to call this thing get color. Now notice I am intentionally copying in all of the settings data because I want to make sure that each call here is getting its own copy of the data. There's no chance of sharing or whatever. And that would be bad in the cases where we can limit it most easily. Now, in C++ 17, we got parallel algorithms, and GCC works with these parallel algorithms. Now, I am telling the standard library that I can run parallel unsequenced. I don't care what order any of these pixels are calculated in, or how many parallel runs are made. So it's completely up to the compiler here if it can, and the runtime, if it can parallelize this. I'm telling it it can, and you can trust me. Let's go ahead and pull this up now. I'm gonna do two things. I'm gonna pull up HTOP. So we can see, like right now, my system is mostly idle and I've got 8 cores available. Now I'm gonna go ahead and rerun with this version with the execution pair unsequenced. And now, keeping in mind these kinds of numbers that we saw 1.79, 1.99, 1.89, and this has two threads running. One is just there's the main thread, and then there's another thread that's running just to update the display whenever it can. All right, so we've recompiled with this parallel unsequenced, and let's go ahead and run this again. And you may have noticed how quickly it came up. I'm going to go back over here so that we can actually see what HTOP is telling us. We have to switch back and forth between these things, but we can immediately see that I'm getting 0.3 seconds. I'm getting pretty much perfect parallelization of my code by changing that one little flag. And now zooming in, I can see just how much faster it can zoom in and that I'm maxing out my system here trying to do this rendering. And I can let go and let it finish doing its calculations here. Yeah, so that finished in 0.13 seconds. We can still zoom right in on the set that we know is about 1.9 seconds to render in this particular coordinates and watch and wait. So it's just iterating over these things, trying to refine the details as much as possible while giving us some feedback. And we can see my two threads here, the main thread and the thread that's looking to say, hey, is there a new image for me to display? Hey, is there a new image for me to display? This code could definitely be better. But yeah, about 0.32 seconds here. So a quite, usable little Mandelbrot renderer and browser if you're into this kind of thing. I always find Mandelbrot to be fun, and of course, pretty pictures, right? Let's see which one of these I end up using for the thumbnail for this episode because it's so rare on C++ Weekly that I actually have some pretty thumbnail. Having all 8 cores maxed out does look nice. That's a nice little area. Happy clouds, that kind of thing. So, thanks for watching this episode of C++ Weekly. Be aware of the parallel algorithms. All of the algorithms in the standard library that can be parallelized are available in Visual Studio, and GCC's standard library implementation is not yet available in LLVM's C++ standard library implementation, unfortunately. So that limits the portability of your code. But Man, you know what? You got the right test case, use case. This is absolutely amazing, right? Like to be able to just get instantly faster code in the case where you've got something that's trivially parallelizable. And certainly not everything, but a lot of problems are. You can see where I reached the limits of my precision down in that little corner there. But yeah, check this stuff out. And thanks for watching this episode of C++ Weekly. Be sure to subscribe.